Hey, what's up? It's the Nitty Gritty Show.
It's the Nitty Gritty.
We're back at you guys.
Good to be back. Welcome to the Nitty Gritty, everybody. Good to be back. Of course, you're here with the Nitty Gritty, and we are Jay DeCosta,
Katniss,
Tay Jordan,
and we are the Nitty Gritty. And we have two special guests on the day, two or three, actually, CTFU Entertainment.
You know what?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, big up to that.
Welcome to the Nitty Gritty, fellas.
Yes.
Thanks for having us.
Absolutely.
Got to. Some of DC's finest comedians out here. I've been following them on Instagram for a minute, and they always, you know, brighten up my day with a good little laugh. And we actually brought them on to talk a little bit about themselves, but then we're going to be talking about relationships a little bit in the DC.
If y'all
don't follow these two guys, and Creep Love, actually, y'all should, because they have a lot of funny stuff that's talking about relationships from a comical view. But then, you know, sometimes they touch on some real subjects that people could talk about. So, you know, that's what we got them here for.
Yes, sir.
But we want to introduce our esteemed guest. We got Waffle Man and Stickum.
Yes, I'm Waffle Man.
And I'm Stickum. All right. That B.I.
Before we go into things, I want people to kind of know a little bit of background on y'all. So, Waffle, we kind of talked about this before we got set up.
Right.
Never did understand where Waffle Man came from, so if you could tell the people.
Okay, well, it's simple. Okay, one day in Southeast, I was on the porch at my brother's spot. You know, we get to Joan and smoking and all that. And it was a little a dyke. She cool. She funny as a mug. And she said, "Nigga, you look like a waffle." And you know, I was heating her up. And I said, you know, I'm going to use that. Because, I mean, I guess I look like a waffle. I don't, you know, like just the palest thing outside at the time. So, that was that.
That's so funny, because you asked earlier, was that like
that's what you said, though.
Thing?
That's why I laughed. I said.
Sort of
he hit it on the nose.
And then Stickum, I know you've been doing this for a while, so, you know, how did you get the name Stickum, too? I was always curious about that. Like, how do you get Stickum Johnson?
Well, basically, name pretty much speaks for itself.
Wear your condoms, everybody. You know?
Growing up, I always wanted to do adult films.
Dang.
So...
I already had my name,
so...
Wait, so are you saying you really wanted to, like, be a porn star?
Yes, I did. That's what I was going to do, you know, until I had children.
You probably, like, sniff feet and all
Yeah,
that.
I was doing everything. I was in practice mode at an early age, so that's how it came about, you know.
Ooh, he dirty.
Well, you seem like you made the right decision. You don't want your kids seeing that later. Like, man, look at daddy. He just sticking everybody.
I think he's still thinking of
porn. You know,
I don't think he's not thinking
it's better that they can see me do these videos rather than see me do those videos. You know?
Yeah, exactly. Good decision. That's what's up. And how long have y'all been doing this? Like the comedy and everything?
12 years. But it's been like
4 years.
So tell us exactly.
We got to give my man Creep a shout out.
Creep,
he can make it.
He in a baby shower? Oh, he could have came.
Crew love. So tell the audience exactly what it is that you guys do. And tell us your social media handles as well. But is it like stand-up or just the segments that you guys do? Because I checked out your IG as well. Y'all mad funny. What got you started in it? And just tell us exactly what it is that you do.
Well, exactly what we do is comedic sketches online. We some online gangsters. So yeah, I'm leaning into the stand up world. Okay. I think he's scared.
Yeah, I'm afraid. I'm staying away from the stand up.
Yeah, he's scared.
Don't be afraid.
It's nothing to be.
It's
afraid
not about
of.
Being afraid, but I'm really not a storyteller. You know, I can act it out better than I can tell a story.
I heard you lie plenty of times.
I ain't never tell no story. I'm quiet. I'm shy for real.
For real?
I'm shy. I'm very shy.
You do some wild stuff in your skits, though, so it's like...
But that's right. On camera. Like, I'm a camera thug. You know, I can do whatever on camera. They say, drop your drink on camera. I'm ready to do it. You know, as soon as the camera come on, that's a whole different story. But
right.
When we out at the parties, it'd be all him. He be dancing, I be quiet.
I'm the vibe god. I like vibes. I like to be in a great atmosphere.
Mm-hmm. Now, y'all sketches, do y'all write y'all sketches or is it improv or how do you guys go about that?
I like improv a lot. You know, he a mastermind. He'll write his
I got to write it up.
I go off of just the vibe sometimes. I write them. I get the idea of them. Mm-hmm. And then sometimes I go as I go.
Is there any kind of inspiration behind the ideas that you come up with?
Real life.
And do you pick the other character? I've seen some of the girls. Are those your friends or are those?
Those are my friends.
Okay.
Those are our friends. You know, and I run into them just off of vibes, you know. And you're like, all right, they want to do it. They do it.
Now, that's where did the concept to actually start come from? Did y'all just wake up one day and be like, man, I'm about to just start banging out these IG videos and we'll see where it goes? Or
how do you guys go about that? Pretty much, we always been the funny guys on the block. And, you know, just...
I used to say
we just
weed.
Put it. Like, we still.
I used to get it.
Told jokes, you know.
Yeah, I did.
At the end of the day, I didn't sell no weed. I didn't do that. Yeah. So
that's all weed.
Trap star turned comedian.
What? Yeah, we told Fattest. Jokes and we was the funny ones. So we just did something with it, yeah. Basically.
Nice. That's what's up.
Yeah.
And you started with the what they call memes.
Yeah, the little pictures, the full pictures or whatever.
He was doing that. Like
you created them.
I created my own. I didn't start it, but I did my own.
No, I'm saying you created your own.
I created my own. I started with pictures because we didn't have the videos at the time on IG.
Okay.
So
that's cool.
And then I seen lately y'all been doing stuff. I think I bigged up you on Instagram for that, but I seen y'all been even branching out to doing stuff with like Jahan Jones. I seen y'all in a couple of videos. I follow him on IG too.
Yeah, so, I mean that's kind of cool. He's from the area. Right. You know, he's a cool guy.
That's what's up. Yeah, but, actually, we've been watching The Wire. And I noticed he had a little small clip in The Wire.
He was on The Wire?
Really? Yeah, like, shit, it was new news to me. Like, she just started watching The Wire for the first time.
Back out?
No.
Here we go. So here...
There's something else that he's on. He's a police officer, right?
It's probably something else, too. But yeah, I just noticed I noticed he was in The Wire.
I've known about The Wire, but I'm late. I always wanted to watch it, and I just decided to start watching. Okay. So that's what that's
but
about.
But he's on The Wire?
Yeah,
he had like a small clip on The Wire. Yeah, like a small episode.
Well, I didn't know that.
Where
that's
he was trying to get
that's
some
good.
Weight, you know what I'm saying?
That's
but they was
good.
Punking
that's
him.
How you do it.
They was
that's
punking
good.
Him, so you can clown him, say they was punking him.
They was punking him?
Yeah.
That's the thing about Jahan, like his skits are like clean. Mm-hmm. You know, more like for the, I don't want to say Caucasian audience. But we more like on the hood side. You know what I'm saying? You know, stuff like that's the difference between us. But yeah, he doing his thing.
Yeah, but I mean, y'all straight DMV, and it's just cool to see people from the DMV always doing it and pushing it out there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, just like this, put out things people can relate
push
to.
It out.
Exactly.
Yeah. You know?
Like, y'all use go-go music in the background and stuff. Like, I'm like, that's what's up. Like, people know where we at. This is DC.
I love every type of music. I be putting everything in that. I'm from everywhere. Mm-hmm. That's what I'm from.
Some people getting phone calls on set. Damn, aren't we popular?
Yeah, you gotta put that, slide that to the left.
Yeah, so we're gonna move forward to the show. We do a little segment where we do a to hell with, and we do a to hell with and the blessings too. So we actually gonna get to hell with. Tay, you had that for us today. Who
yeah,
we going
I got
to
it to
with?
Hell with. You want to start with the bad first or the good first?
Man, we'll say the hell with first.
Yeah, okay.
We'll
go ahead. Well, this week's to hell with. So to hell with is really where we call out each week somebody that's been a bonehead for the week or said some outlandish dumb stuff. So this week. The to hell with, I'm saying to Serena Williams critics, if you guys do not know, Serena Williams recently released news that she's engaged, and here most recently she released news that she is expecting.
Pregnant.
So congrats to Serena.
Yeah.
But I'm saying to hell with all her critics on Instagram, because it's a lot of particularly, no disrespect in generalization, but a lot of black men on Twitter did not like the fact that she is not only marrying a non-black man, but having a child by her fiance, her soon-to-be husband, and they just went in on her. So I'm saying to hell with all of her critics, because, you know, it's not rare for black men to marry outside their race, so I just found it very ironic that they would come sideways at her. So to hell with Serena Williams critics.
Yeah, I'm going to follow suit and say to hell with, because I know from following her that she's had some dating struggles.
Right. And she's dated black men.
She has, and... No one put a ring on it. Now she has a white guy who put a ring on it, and now they're having a kid. I'm congratulating her. I'm happy for her.
It'd be like that sometimes. And, you know, I guess she took a lot of criticism as well. I guess she was just quoted for saying that from her, and she just was saying her experience. You can't get really mad at people's experience. But anyway, she was quoted as saying that non-black men treat her better. And from her experience, obviously she dated Drake, Common. She's had black boyfriends. And
Drake is such a, like,
he's from?
Toronto.
All their food is raw to eat. They don't eat no cooked food there.
Oh, really?
I don't know.
Yeah, tofu.
tofu.
Like he does baby sauce.
Tofu in Canada. But yeah, to hell with Serena Williams critics this week, for sure.
That's what's up. And as far as like blessings too, we always give blessings too, so we try to balance it out, right?
Okay.
We shout blessings, and I think we couldn't decide between two, so we just gonna shout them both out.
Right.
But both released books this week. Both of them are black authors. Of course, we all know Charlemagne the God. He put out his Black Privilege book. So I'm definitely going to be copping that on my Audible account. Yeah, definitely. Yeah. And then also shout out one of my favorite novelists is Eric Jerome Dickey. He put out Finding Gideon. And actually, it's dope. Like, if anybody's ever read Zane, you know, it's a lot of sex in it and all that, but it's actually got a storyline. It's kind of erotic. But it's actually dope. Like, the dudes get into it. Like, the dude Gideon is actually like an assassin. Yeah. So it's pretty cool. Yeah, so he did 4 books. He went ghost on it for a long time, said... People weren't really buying it like they were buying the other stuff. So finally, there was enough people out there begging, like, yo, release another Gideon book. I was one of them hitting them up on Facebook all the time. So he put out Finding Gideon. I ain't going to say it was up to me, but I like to believe that
you helped contribute.
I was the influencer to get it done. Yeah, I had some pool with it. So, you know, shout out to Eric Jerome Dickey. So, yeah, blessings to them putting out their books. If you read, you definitely should pick them up. If you don't read, just get the book and just sit with it inside.
You don't read,
boys.
You better start reading.
Or at least front. Because like it was a dude on the cruise we was just on. He was reading some book about something. So I asked him about it, and Cat couldn't tell me nothing. So obviously, he's just fronting for all the females on the boat. He was looking real studious. Yeah. Oh, yeah. So, you know.
That's it. That sounds like something that would be me. That come out with a movie. I look at it then, you know.
Yeah. So, I mean, even if you don't read, just get the book and pretend to read it so you look like you know what's going on, right?
Right.
You end up in that situation.
But since we're talking about relationships, do you guys feel like women like smart guys or studious guys in your experience?
No.
Different
type of women. The project women, I don't think.
Yeah, he talking
really
about
care.
The woman he deal with.
Yeah, I don't really think. I like hood chicks.
You like hood chicks. Can you define what exactly is a hood chick?
A chick you get into an argument with, she say she gonna call her brother to fuck you up and, you know, get the blaze and shit like that. You know, that's what I like, you know.
So you feel comfortable in a drama field?
No, like, I be scared, but I can handle myself, you know. But that's, I don't know. I think some women don't like a nice guy. Some women do.
Yes.
It's
definitely. Yeah, I would agree. It's women that definitely like smart men who up on that shit, you know, up on that stuff. Then it's something that like wild niggas. I don't know. And it's some, I mean, a good woman that like wild niggas. Mm-hmm. I don't know.
What is a wild nigga?
A wild nigga is, he bars a car every Tuesday through Thursday. You know what I'm saying? He bring her back late, pick her up late. He fuck other bitches in the
car.
Car.
Oh,
he
wow.
You know what I'm saying? He always get locked up every third month.
And she got bail him out.
So for what y'all call wild niggas, is it just the expectations that y'all gotta, like, wild niggas gotta do wild things? Like, you gotta,
pretty much, that's how you get the name.
That wild nigga?
Yeah, that's, they don't even know.
Like,
and when you tell them, and when you say you a wild nigga, he
wait,
get
how?
Mad. That's how
am
you know
I
a
wild nigga? What I do?
I ain't a wild nigga. You a wild nigga. When you say that, that's a wild nigga.
Yeah. Now tell us a little bit of, you know, none of us are from here. Well, me and Katrina are from Cleveland. Yeah. So coming to D.C., obviously.
Y'all
heard,
from Cleveland?
Yeah.
Y'all seen that shit? What's up with y'all boy?
Yeah, that's y'all man.
Wild nigga.
Steve
that's
Stevenson.
He wild.
I like to try her boo.
That motherfucker.
That incident can happen anywhere. You know
that was just Cleveland.
It would have been stopped right
there. That stuff happened in D.C.
That would have been stopped right as soon as it happened here. He drove around.
Anyway.
We're talking about Cleveland. We're not talking about
D.C.
No,
we were talking about D.C. though. We were talking about D.C. And before coming here, obviously I heard that it's Chocolate City. It's good dating here. So speak about it a little bit.
Who was going to that lie?
I heard about Chocolate City, but I ain't heard about no good dating.
I heard about Chocolate City, and now it's not even all the way chocolate no more. So no races. It's just it's not the same Chocolate City it used to be.
It's
so,
cream stuff feel,
right?
For sure.
You know what I mean? Look at me. I'm supposed to be brown. I'm not. So you know, no Chocolate City, and it's no luck.
Ain't
who
no
told
love,
you
it
was
yeah
good love here? Why would they?
No, I mean, coming in,
was it
you
on the
a lot
of
stuff,
on the little
like,
flyer, the Washington? They
not
be
on
mad.
The flyer, just word of mouth.
Welcome to DC. Good dating.
They were saying DC had a lot of educated blacks here. The Howard community.
They, you know what
and
they
you can
do.
You know
they do
find your significant other here, and then you get here, you're like.
They hiding. They're not. They're not. You can't just spot them.
They're called undercover brothers. That's what they are. You know? That's what they are.
You funny.
I don't know. I don't think it's love no more in this generation. I don't know.
Yeah,
everybody just
I don't.
Looking
know.
To,
but
looking
why do you?
Hit.
Why
no,
do
it
you
is love.
Is?
But I think
why I think it's no more love because they wasn't loved as a kid. I guess I don't know. I don't know why it's no more love, but. I guess the way females carry themselves nowadays, I don't know. I don't know.
Like, how would you say females carry themselves nowadays?
Whew, you digging yourself in that
motherfucker. No, I'm saying, like,
I'm carrying yourself. I see your lifeboat. I got the lifeboats over here. Don't worry, I got you.
Nah,
you
well, somebody, I'm throwing. Somebody help me. Tag me. Goddamn it.
I'll interrupt and say, I think it is love still here, but I think the perception of love is way different than what it really is.
Mm-hmm.
It's not just about the natural feeling no more. It's some other shit. Glossy, flashy shit. I don't know. It's different.
What
but it's
has
not,
distorted people's views on the concept
maybe
of
television,
love,
maybe music.
Media. Love and hip hop.
Social media.
Yeah.
And it just could be that generation. You know, I'm an offspring of my mom, she good, but I think like after her, those women, they was drug dealers, girlfriends, and then they cut dope when they got locked up. They did a lot. So, you know, it's different.
Uh-huh.
The moral they follow is different. So
I think
we fucked up.
Look, I think you hit it earlier when you said media. I mean, y'all pretty much like TV
right.
and all that stuff,
yeah.
right? And she hear me say this all the time. Anybody who know me hear me say it all the time. Like, you know, people are so quick to come at the guys, but then we got to come at the programming that a lot of women are taking in. And I'm not saying it's all on the women, but at the same time, like, you know, I've been in relationships before where, you know, people didn't watch too much TV, so they expect to get certain types of treatment. And it's like, at the end of the day, though, she married to a ball player. I ain't no ball player. I ain't bringing in that kind of money.
Nope.
So, you know, we ain't getting it like that. You're not about to get like a 8-carat diamond ring and maid service, you know.
Mean?
But girls out here now is on different. And then it's kind of hard to be like, be wholesome. But you got Nicki Minaj selling booty, getting paid.
Right.
You got J-Lo selling booty, getting paid.
Uh-huh.
I mean, all the housewife chicks, they selling booty. And getting paid, and even if you don't got a booty, go and inject one and get paid, right? So it's kind of like, it's like at some point, the whole fabric of what used to be black is different. And I kind of like the fact that in y'all skits, y'all kind of like, without getting too deep into it, no Farrakhan type of movement, but y'all do point out a lot of cool stuff. Like, I know you was doing stuff like on Netflix and Chill that was just funny, but it's just like, now the whole dating thing, you know, no one got to take nobody out no more. Now you just kind of like get the Netflix and Chill together.
Yeah. Right.
You got some funny spins on it though.
Right,
you know,
right.
You definitely could tell, you could tell them about that. Mm-hmm. You know, I didn't see them all.
Well, you know, those Netflix and Chill, that's real. Sometimes, I mean, well, mine have been successful a lot.
You got your account together.
Yeah. I still use my brother's, and he used somebody else. Look, sometimes I try to get on there like 3:00, and they say it's too many devices. I be like, damn, man, he gave that password out to everybody. But I mean, it's funny because some of the skits I do, it's not all about what happens to me. My mind thinks a million times per second, so it's about just anything. Like, I can drop a pen and just think, like, damn, what if I was in a grocery store and a lady hit me in the car, and then I flew, and then a nigga, you know what I mean, ran me over, and then I hit my head on the glass, and I got killed. Like, I think too much. So it's an offspring of what really happened. So I think that'd be funny sometimes. Of course, I get the cheeks, but then I think, what if I didn't? You know what I mean?
That's what I hit with that.
Interesting.
Can we
not just about sex.
Can we talk about this getting the cheeks? So
getting the cheeks, okay.
Getting the cheeks. So they're after getting the cheeks. Do you still keep in contact with
I'm a gentleman.
Men?
Can I tell you one story?
Okay.
And she probably knows I'm pinpointing to her. So I got to know someone a while ago. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I want to say about a year ago, after my last relationship. I didn't even get to know her. I got to talking to her. She had a lot going on and whatever we was talking. That shot off, and, you know, another year went by. She hits me out of nowhere. We get to talking about it together, whatever. She wanted me to come over, I come over. I got the cheeks. Next morning, I hit her with the "Hey, good morning, how you doing?" You know, give it. You know, I'm responding. So I hit her with the smirk emoji. Like, she was like, she had a good time. Well, I definitely had a good time. I hit her with the, you know what I mean? And she said, "What kind of face is that? You up to no good? You like a fuck boy?" I said, "What?" I just said good morning. Like, I'm reaching back out. If I was gonna hit it quit, I wouldn't have texted you. So it's wild. I don't know.
So, like, do y'all know going in, like, okay, this girl, I kind of just want to get the cheeks.
You know who you, yeah, you know who, and I tell them the truth. So, and they,
you
know, sometimes it don't work, you know, I respect you. And then a year later, they probably come back.
They can always come back running.
Because they be seeing the dance videos. I be wearing my little sweats and shit.
That's so funny.
No,
nah, but
crazy.
So I'm gonna share a little story with you guys. So on my Facebook, I'm always talking about different controversial things. So we was talking about relationships and this whole shared splitting expenses. So you're in a relationship, right, with the girl. Y'all been rocking 2 years or so, and you guys decided you want to move in together.
Right.
So some men really came down on me because I felt like I made the statement. I made the status that said, if you're going half and half with your girl on the bills, then you have a roommate, not a girlfriend.
Yeah, I definitely had a roommate.
I got a roommate.
But that wasn't. She was holding shit down. I ain't gonna lie. But that's tough though to be in that position. Mm-hmm. It's kids involving shit. She was holding shit down. I was trying to do what I could do, but she got it. She got all respect for me for that. And it puts you in a weird position because you're supposed to
woman
be
to like, you know,
no.
Or is it, do y'all go, when you're in a relationship, do you want to split or you be like,
I want
to
split.
Look, if I'm in a position to do that and I, you know, and I'm not losing nothing, she ain't just going shopping and doing whatever, I can take care, you know.
Okay. But not what me. About, now you said you
I don't think
split,
things going to last forever, so, you know.
Oh,
I'm on that type, you know, you do your stuff, I do my stuff, you know. Okay. And then if I do prenup, pay all the bills.
The pre-prenup. Agreement.
Then I'm gonna do what I want to do. I'm gonna cheat.
So you know,
if I got to pay all the bills, I'm gonna.
Shit.
I'm lazy, you know.
Wait, what is the rationale behind that? Like, you feel like
I pay all the bills, so I do what I want to do. You know,
I don't get that way.
You know, that's how I feel.
That's how I feel.
You know, I'm gonna do what I want to do.
Isn't a man a provider?
That's what he's supposed to do.
Yeah, you're supposed to provide.
I couldn't catch a fish. Yeah, me.
I'm trying to provide other women too. You know.
So my question to you is a twofold question. Question number one: the woman that you're messing with, do they know that that is a part of the package deal? Knowing that if you provide, you're more than likely gonna cheat on them. And question number two: do you like the drama?
We got to stick with one question. Hold on. What's the first question again? Do they know I'm going to cheat?
Do the women have an expectation of your kind of behavior possibly in a living situation?
No, but I'm pretty sure they know what's going on.
They know what's going on. Yeah. My next question.
As long as I'm not disrespectful with it, you know.
You got single in a relationship? What?
Oh, I'm single.
Right now, I'm
you in between?
I'm single, but my baby mother stays with me.
Oh, okay. That's
interesting. We're not together.
Oh.
It's weird.
Now, are you guys understanding that we're not together? So does that mean you can see other women and she can see other men and bring them to the house and like?
No, you can't bring nobody to the house. She does what she do. I don't ask her no questions.
But okay, can she bring?
No, she cannot bring nobody. That's my house.
I'm gonna want to go over there anyway.
So you don't have to bring women to the house either, right?
No, I got a car. In the parking lot.
So she doesn't have a car.
Hotel mobile.
Yeah, she got a car too.
No, he's saying he'll handle his business in the car.
Oh.
Yeah. You know?
Don't bring it to the house.
I wouldn't bring nobody. That's my daughter stayed there.
You're gonna make these girls Steve Stevens.
Yeah, I ain't gonna.
To me, that sounds like
a
recipe for drama, peace. But for some reason I feel like you like that kind of high intensity.
Drama, but I'm gonna do what I wanna do. You know?
With no
restraint. That's why I'm not in a relationship.
If it looks
so why
like
live together then?
Because my daughter and her mother needed a place to stay. So
if it quack like a duck.
Sucked it up, you know, and let her move with me.
So is it possible that you guys can work it out?
No. Oh. Yeah. No.
Okay.
No.
I got you. Next
time. Yeah. No, when we was talking about that, it kind of segues into like one thing that you do on your skits, Stick'em. You do a side chick, main chick.
And I believe in side chicks. They are everything to me.
Ooh, explain.
Side chicks, they work so much harder to keep your attention. Mm-hmm. You know, main chicks, they already got you. So it's like they're coming to bed with the scarf on their head. You don't really get sex too much. You know, if I'm driving down the street, I'm like, boo, can I have some head? The main chick, I'm like, no. Side chick, can I have some head? You know, she's going to do what she need to do.
You
going to do it. You know, it's just exciting. The side chick is so much
Oh, I know what
fun.
He's saying. He's saying that so once you there for a minute,
yeah, once you're comfortable,
dull, the whole
you feel like you ain't
got to
do that
becomes
stuff no more.
So do you ever, have you ever had a situation where your side piece became your main piece?
Have you ever slipped up on your game?
Have I had a situation where my side piece became my main piece?
I think so.
My side piece actually became both of our main piece.
Damn.
At one time.
Ooh.
That boy got gay.
But that didn't last for long.
Oh, so you didn't pull a D-Ray Davis and just keep
I pulled
that thing
a D-Ray
going.
Davis, but
oh, okay.
He was getting his Lou
But
Will
I
on.
Just yeah. I got
said,
jealous. I ain't like
hell
that
too,
shit.
Though.
You know, once you see them having sex with each other, like, oh, what are you doing? Oh, wait for me. You know, like, don't do it without me. But they kept doing it without me. So like, we can't do this
out.
No more. Aww. You know?
Yeah.
You know? You felt left out.
I ain't feel left out, but it's just I'm a one-sided person. I can do this, but you can't do
this. So what's the wildest thing you've ever done? Because it seems like you have a wild history.
What you mean wildest thing? Like sexual wise?
If we're gonna go there, then
I can't really think of that. I had sex on my uncle's pickup truck in his garage. I don't know.
Fucking dirty.
I really can't think of nothing.
So dirty.
Too wild sex outside my school. Outside my workplace. I don't know.
Oh, he gets it in. No, you said at the end there that you...
That's it? That's all you get?
So what about you, Waffle?
I'm pretty sure he got more wild stuff than I do.
In the Macy's.
In the Macy's. Hold up. Like, was this the men's aisle? The men's section?
In men's aisle. What? In the woman's bathroom, as you may. But anyway, who's asking? But let's see. On a playground in Clinton. And it was like neighbors.
There, was it?
Hell nah. It was like 2 a.m.
Okay.
Look crackheads.
I was getting it in. Nah, you ain't Clinton, ain't no crackheads.
Oh yeah,
out. Sure. Yeah, ain't Clinton. No, but the neighbor was like, "Man, get on out of here, make all that goddamn noise." I was cranking her, son. But crushing her.
Tear that ass up.
God, I was crushing her.
You had a condom.
We still good friends to this. Yeah, I had a condom.
No, you ain't really fuck her too good.
I think I had a condom.
Wait a minute.
I fucked her good. But with the condom.
Yeah,
But let's see, what else?
Yeah, I don't really be doing no big wild places.
I mean, I like hotels.
I
got
to get
like
butt naked.
You know, I might like to chill too, though.
I got to go half on that. Really,
but you got to go half on a hotel?
Yeah, we should, I think. Because, I mean, she probably got a boyfriend 9 times out of 10. And that's how they go.
Interesting.
Yeah, girls cheat too.
That's how they go. They
girls cheat too. Those are the best girls to cheat with.
I'm not saying all y'all.
And these are all women all here in the D.C. area that you're talking about. Most
women.
Yep.
Murray girls are the best. Too.
Murray girls are
the best. I like New York. New York
type. Did you mess with married women?
Well, she's married to another woman.
I've messed with a married woman.
Oh wow. Yeah. Now you said at the tail end of one of your statements beforehand, and you was like, I'm a one-sided man. Now I find that being like, it seems to be like a male perspective, like something for nothing. You know what I'm saying? Would you say that that's like that. Is that your ego? Like, I can do this, but you can't do this.
I know plenty of women that do that too.
Yeah.
Women, well, I know some women that do that.
Like, it's like this false sense of entitlement.
A female walk by, I have sex with her.
Damn.
Have no feelings with her. I don't have no feelings. I'm not attached to her.
How quick?
You know, we
that?
Meet each other, you know, and all that. But I feel like if a female give her body up to a man, she has feelings for him.
Okay.
You know, it's something there. Facts.
So for a man to give his body up to a woman, it's like,
I'm
just trying to get a nut.
Damn.
So let me get this straight. You're saying
you're a hoe?
Yeah, something like that. I told her I wanted to do porn.
Oh yeah,
that's
true.
The only way I can do
that. Yeah, that is true.
You know,
he said that.
So back to what Shantae is saying, you don't think that there is a sense of entitlement that men think, oh, I can just pick my body and do what I want, but if a female tries it, you feel as though that she has some kind of feelings. I know women who have sex and there are no feelings attached.
I know some too, though.
Those are hoes.
So you can have a sexual appetite and you have a desire.
You
to
should have one partner.
But, women should have one partner. Yeah. So men, y'all don't play by those same rules.
No. A man can have sex with 55 females and be considered a man, but a female has sex with 55 men, and she's a hoe.
So you live under society standards. You
that's
say that because
yeah,
society
standards. Yeah,
probably.
I know girls probably got like 100 up under their belt.
Interesting.
And that's not, would you wife them?
It depends.
What if the same man who slept with 55 women is giving all these women some kind of STD or something?
Why
is that
you
okay?
Going so far like that?
I have to go there.
You have to. It's a society. You gotta.
Is that problematic to you, or do you think, hey,
that's not cool?
The territory.
I'm not thinking like that's what he's going to do, or I don't. That's a whole different story.
Do you have a daughter or a son? You have a daughter.
I have both.
Okay, now let me ask you this. What's the lady name?
When
men have this perspective and they have children, especially daughters. So do you have a daughter?
That's why I changed of how I treat women while I'm in a relationship with them. So
but
now
do you think
I'm
that
single.
You fully changed and you still say things?
I haven't
like
changed, so that's why I'm not doing a female dirty because I'm not with her.
Okay.
I used to be with females and still do what I want.
Mm.
So ever since I had a daughter. I'm like, I don't want my daughter to be treated
that's,
like that.
That's good. Aww, right there.
You know? Got a conscience.
Yeah, right. I do have a conscience. I got a conscience a little bit, but at the end of the day, I would teach my daughter, you know, she would be loved by her father, so she wouldn't really be care to be loved by nobody else.
I mean, she gonna
need that
happy.
Attention from another man. Uh-huh. You know?
Would you want your daughter to marry a man like you?
No, hell no.
Good answer.
No.
That's
great
real.
Answer. Right.
So, let me ask you this.
As far as like taking care of your responsibility, I do that, you know, but I just gotta, everybody got like an addiction. Like, you know, people smoke, people what drink.
Are yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's I'm true. Addicted to
foot females. Sex.
Yeah. I fuck feet and all that. I do all that. You really? Know? I'm addicted to feet. I lust real hard.
Stick with Johnson just out here.
I lust real hard.
So you got old boy from Boomerang. You just got that yeah, feet thing. You got ugly
toes,
feet.
I suck the polish off of bitch toes. I do what I need to do. You know? I'm nasty.
All types of ethnicities, age discrimination, or young and old, just...
Even if they had a history of athlete's foot.
21 and older, so like a fine 70-year-old, you still would?
Yeah, I'm an old bitch. If the price is right. You know?
Except if the price was right, though.
Yeah. What the fuck? Because you know she's going to do something for you. You know, she,
oh,
she
I mean,
gonna
yeah,
look out for
so.
You. Baby, you got the car no pain? I'm like, no, Miss Sherry, I don't. I'm going to take this. You know?
What about interracial dating? Do you guys date outside your race?
Yeah, oh, man, I had me a white girl one day. But she went all the way. She was
one
Oreo white.
Day.
Wait,
and she tasted so good.
Wait, she was an Oreo white.
Yeah.
That's the reverse, because Oreos are black on the outside, white on the inside.
They got a new Oreo coming around Christmas time.
She was a white girl with black.
White, you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, I knew where you was going with that. Yeah, I caught you.
Right. I ain't really had no full throttle Becky. I went to Delaware. You know.
And my man's laughing. He's like
really
full throttle Becky.
Yeah, I ain't really had no Becky. I went to, what was that, Delaware University? Mm-hmm. And my man put me in a room with, you know, a white girl. I was just so scared. That's when that shit with Kobe Bryant was going on with the rape. I was just, I wanted her, but I was scared to put myself in there. I said, man, come get me out of this room. You know, I just ain't want to be put in that predicament, you know. But
that's so funny.
Now, they was getting on you. I was trying to help you out, but they wouldn't even let me, you know, get in and try
it's
to throw
okay.
you a lifeboat. Okay. But they was talking about double standards with, you know, men. Now, obviously, I'm a man on the show, so, you know, I'm not going to, like, agree with everything. And I feel like there's a lot of double standards with women. And you did a skit not too long ago. It was a situation with a phone. And I've actually been to this before. Girl, want to go through your phone. The second you say, let me go through yours. Oh, yeah. Heck no.
Exactly.
Why are you trying to go on my phone? Let me call my mama. You know what I'm saying? Like, it go crazy when you try to look in that phone, too. So, it's like,
flip.
there's a lot of flip double standards. Do y'all see that a lot in relationships with women? I mean, because, I mean, obviously, y'all make a lot of comedy. Not everything is personal, but I'm pretty sure a lot of it is just what you visualize.
Everything personal for me. I go through most of that stuff.
Yeah.
You know, I just try to make humor of it. I got a lot of baby mama drama. Before she was a baby mama, I still had a lot of female drama. Uh-huh. And that's, you're right, that's what I liked at the time. That's why I think, you know, when females, like, calling you bitches and trying to get you fucked up, I think, like, oh, she care about me. She like me. You know,
she's
doing all this.
She
like
it. She does. Yeah. You know what I mean?
That's
what I thought love was. But now I'm
function.
Old now. Like, I don't want to go through all that.
Mm-mm.
You know, I don't want to go through all that. That's too much now.
It's cute when you're younger, though. It's cute. Like you know, like, maybe not. I may not want that much drama, but it's cute when you're younger
shit,
and, like, the girl kind of flip out a little
about
bit.
That shit.
So when you start having kids and, like, you know, you decide, like, this really not going to work out with the mother of my child. So that's going to be my baby mother. So do you your next relationship? Do you have you? I guess naturally you have that expectation, like the next woman I'm with, she's gonna have to accept me for my baby mama drama. And
I don't have no baby mama drama. Both my baby mamas cool with each other.
I thought you said
I got baby mama drama, but they don't have. They talk to each other when you come.
Well, you
get
got baby mama
no,
drama.
No, I'm saying so. Your next girlfriend is gonna have to. You have the expectations that she know that she gonna have to deal with that.
I think with the newest baby mama, she will have baby mama drama.
So, yeah. Like, how do you prepare the girlfriend? Like, hey, this what it is. This is my. It's a package deal.
I don't really see myself having no girlfriend no time soon. You know.
Okay. So you kind of setting yourself down in the dating arena, huh?
Yeah, I'm just not ready. You know, if I come across a female that's willing to give me what I want, then I guess I'll settle down. But I feel like what I want is not even a lot. I just want her to invite other females into the bedroom. I want dinner at a certain time.
God, damn, you're looking at a president.
And I do want her to, I want her to pay, she ain't even got to pay half the bills, you know, pay a quarter of the bills, you know. I handle the rent and all the bills and stuff. You just get the groceries and the deodorant and whatnot.
Teamwork. That's teamwork. You know. I like teamwork.
Now what about
I like
you?
Teamwork.
Are you sitting out of the dating arena or are you in it? You want to
I'm around, but I'm trying to focus. You know, that stuff get me off guard. It really do. I figure that out. I'm trying to focus right now.
Tell me what it is. Relationships, what we do, females don't really approve of what we do.
Being a comedian?
Nah, I think the right one would, though.
They don't approve of what we do.
In terms of, you guys growing your presence on social media, did you notice, as you became bigger and got more visibility, more followers came, the more, do Instagram stars got, groupies and stuff? Do y'all deal with that?
I'm in the 5,000 section. I don't have groupies. I still may have to pay for sex.
What about you, Nustin?
Ain't nothing.
I wouldn't call them groupies.
They slide in your DM, seeing what's up, or no?
The funny thing is, they used to do that, when I was in a relationship. And then when I got single, they just looked
down
at me. Yeah, I'm like, what?
That's yeah, cool. So when you bring up women, when they be messing up, I ain't trying to act like I bash women, but I got to balance out, you know what I'm saying? I got to be the balance of the day, you know what I'm saying? Because they going to go on it. You know, right. When the sisters get together, and sisters is watching right now, agreeing with them, they going in on you. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So I got to be the balancer.
I apologize. My angry black sisters.
Hey, look, I'm not. Hey, look, sometimes I hang with him.
We together, goddamn. Nah, he feel the same way I feel.
No, I do
y'all
not.
Y'all mad and angry for no reason.
No, I'm the vibe guy. I don't believe in none of that he's talking about, ladies.
God bless y'all.
Y'all should have y'all back rubbed every second of the day.
He's a damn lie.
Y'all should. Y'all hard working woman.
Amen.
That's what's up.
And it's a lot of bammers that think of funny right now where he take care of his kids. There's a lot of bammers that don't.
Yes.
So I feel for the woman that, they got niggas, bammers, whatever you want to call them like that. Wild ass niggas.
Wild
ass. That's the wild ass niggas.
That's crazy. How you not want to be in your child's life, right?
Mm-hmm. You got a that's Gucci crazy. Belt and you fly that night.
That's a blessing.
Mm-hmm. And you're not in your child's life.
Now, and what do y'all say about those situations where you have it where, on the flip side, right? So people love to say that men don't like to be in the children's lives.
Oh, I see.
What about the situations where the man wants to, but it's financially beneficial, or...
He should be a babysitter, though.
No, I'm talking about those situations where the guy takes care of what he needs to take care of, but the women use the children as a weapon to keep the guys away.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm a victim of that.
Yeah, I had that too.
Yeah.
I had that too.
Not my son and my mom. I mean, my son and his mom, but I don't talk about it. Actually, I do. My mom is a wild lady. I ain't even gonna say ass nothing. She a wild lady, but I know it's out of love. Mm-hmm. But sometimes, when you withhold somebody from somebody's life, the little boy can grow up and he might have been a little different. And now you telling me that you held that. I thought the dude ain't fuck with me. You know what I mean? My father. Anyway, let's go. Move on. So a woman can do that. You know what I mean? For no reason. He wanted to be around. He wanted to care for me.
Fair.
He wanted to see me, whatever. And she didn't allow it because of her feelings. Aww. Unfair.
Right.
But I'm past. I'm grown. That's my man. That's my dog. And they're back together. That's fucking crazy.
Wow, look at that.
They're back together.
What
so that's wrong, though, That could be wrong.
That's real.
Well,
that's interesting.
That's very interesting.
Something I've seen both of y'all do skits about. So, I'm going to kind of, get some of the inspiration from these. They're hilarious to me. Y'all do these skits around tax time. Where, maybe people want to get back together because it's like, hey, let's split this tax money.
Split that tax money.
Or, maybe you're doing bad. So, hey, baby, what's up? You know what I'm saying? But, I've seen it done in both ways. You know what I'm saying? So, if y'all could speak on that a little bit because that was funny. And it's still kind of relevant. I mean, I don't know if any of those relationships are still together because, the tax money already came. So, I guess they got to pretend to be a family for one more month.
Mine ain't come yet. Mine come always come August, September, October. They got my name under the FU file. I don't know. They never give me my money on time.
Tax time is just one baby mother. I try to become the world's greatest baby daddy. I'm already a good father, but I be calling her, I need some groceries in the house and stuff like that, even for her other kids. I'm trying to look out. But then can I get the Social Security? No. What make you think you deserve it? I'm like, all right. wait till next year. Then she tell me in the middle of the year, oh, I'll let you claim if you do this. So she keep getting me every goddamn time. One year, I'm just say, you know, forget it. You know, just...
That's what know. I don't like, though. You know what I mean?
Baby mothers are shiesty, man. They the devil.
Yeah, it's a lot of them that's money hungry, though.
Exactly.
And especially so
just,
out of being spiteful.
Just going through that experience in the first time around and it not being the best experience, does that make you just not for not to happen the second time around? Like, do you learn your lesson? Like, okay, the next baby I have is going to be about my wife, or do you kind of, like, keep bumping your head? Like,
personally, I was in love with both of my baby mothers just once. It's wrong to say, but after I see that birth, I just be so disgusted.
You disgusted by the birth?
Yeah, like turn me off. You know,
we ain't never
like,
gonna make
I'm
it.
I'm sorry, this. Man. It's just once I see all that,
I had a woman's.
It just why enough. You over there shaking your head like that? Don't shake your head like that. But I just be like, it just turned me off for some reason.
Turn her off. Turning you off from ever like having sex with her again?
I still have sex, and I'm a hoe. But
so if I turn you off like how? Like if not sexually? Like,
this is just like. I don't know. It just, know. It's just not, it's like, okay, don't do it for me no more.
Time to leave.
You see a lot during childbirth. I mean, you see the baby come through. They always boo-boo. Or at least, you know, you see a little bit of boo-boo.
Yeah, both of them shitting on themselves. Like, if I was shit on mine, I'm pretty sure they wouldn't like me no more. I actually peed in the bed with one girl.
Ugh,
wait a minute.
And I've been with her for 4 years.
How old?
I was 21. I've been with her for 4 years. And I left that day, and I never talked to her again.
You peed in her bed?
I peed in her bed.
That's just
she had a raccoon in her attic. So I really wasn't too fond of getting up, you know, going to the bathroom.
So you peed on purpose?
I didn't pee on purpose, but you know when you had, like, that dream when you were at the bathroom?
Man.
You ever had that dream when you were at the bathroom?
I did. I've had that dream before. I mean,
and I did, and I was so honest with her. I said, damn. She said, what? I said, I peed in the bed. And she just looked at me and was like...
Damn,
I kissed her. I said, "All right, bye. I'll talk to you later, baby." I've been calling her, and you know,
oh, she never
it was Kiki. Kiki, I love the
shout
Kiki
out
too.
Kiki.
That's where you at. Damn, that's a rough way to mess it up.
I hope we got you some new sheets, Kiki. Wherever you at.
That was a good girl. I was pee
mattress
on her.
The mattress wasn't even all that.
I mean, but R. Kelly did it on purpose. So I mean,
he did it on purpose. And then you in a spooner position, right? So did you pee on her?
I can't remember. I know I had a raid Arizona that night.
Oh,
yeah. So it went right through your system, man. Like, yeah, that kind of stuff. You had to
all
prep
sugar
yourself.
So I know you guys have a lot of followers, and you do.
I got 5,000. I would like to have more.
A lot of videos. My question is: has this become lucrative for you? Have you received any kind of sponsorship? What is your next move? You know, thereafter the DMV, since you guys are becoming really, really big in the area.
The next move. Like he said, he want to do stand up.
Okay.
I want to get into movies and stuff like that. That's what I'm trying
to
do. I'm trying to get into movies.
Dope. Now
but I'm not gonna say I'm sitting up here, you know, making myself a slave. You know, I'm not going to auditions and all. I'm just.
Do people hit you up like, you know, like, hey man, like, I want you in this production, blah blah blah.
Maybe get some of them people, but it's like it's not like no Spike Lee or them, you know, type people. But, you
know, people that start their own.
Like just starting their, you know,
like
starting just like we start.
I like. Dealing with that too.
Yeah, but you know, it's not like no big roles that's going to be on TV or anything like that.
Yeah, work for that.
Now, how is it in the DC market as far as like the pulse in terms of the comedy market here? Do everybody pretty much know each other and that's on the circuit? Is it like love on the circuit? Is it like a crabs in a barrel type of thing? How that work?
In the comedy field, I think it's a whole lot of love. I think it's a whole lot of love, but. Everybody's comfortable with who they already with.
So right,
it's
that's
like clicks.
Yeah.
You're comfortable with who you are, so you know.
Yeah.
I'm gonna work with them.
Right.
Instead of, you know, going to collab with somebody else.
Right. Now, how did you guys come together? Tell us a little bit as far as the making of teams CTFU.
But how did we meet each other? Or?
Yeah, like how did you guys like, come together and become a team?
We already been a team. I mean, like you said, he used to sell drugs. I think I sold something with him sometime. I can't remember.
Nah, she wanna know how we met.
You wanna know how we met? Like, really met?
We're mutual friends.
How did y'all come together? Like, you do this comedy shit, I do this comedy shit. Like,
that ain't,
let's get together.
Oh, we gotta start over how we...
Oh, well, you want...
We gotta start over how we met,
how
though.
How many minutes you got?
We got time. We got time.
Yeah, you want to start off?
Well, it was this little bony girl named China. It was our man Steve that we knew.
That sounds like it's about to be a story. All
right. It's a story. Yeah, it's a story. Hey, watch how he can do a stand-up.
It's not. I'm going to do this very dry, so it won't sound like no stand-up. So basically, Steve called China. China came. He ended up calling Waffle. Waffle like, tell her I'm going to be there with a tank top with some Tims on. I'm a fucker and all that. He was just saying a whole lot of stuff. I'm like, oh, this dude funny. You know, he just said a whole rocket joke.
Why did y'all call me? Because she said she wasn't trying to do nothing or something.
Yeah, she
without
was,
me.
She said she wasn't trying to do nothing without him. I was scared regardless, you know. I never seen nothing like that. She was just ready. So he ended up coming over there, and it was supposed to be like
I had things to do. I was upset. You know what I'm saying? I treated sex like it was a business. So them I had other appointments. Yeah. So they took me off. I said, all right, look, I'm coming over there to handle this shit. I got like, I'm going to get it started. And I got to go. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. So, but he didn't even get it started. We got there. We all sitting in the basement. We looking at TV. The girl said, so I know y'all ain't bring me down here just to look at TV. I'm like, ooh, it scared me. I'm like, oh, my God. Next thing I know, he dropped his drawers. The dude, Steve, walked out. So she just started bopping them off. I'm like, oh, man. And I'm just... No homo, but I'm looking.
I'm looking. He's looking.
I guess you got to say pause.
Like, he said, you want some of this, cuz?
It's no, said, it's no, not. Like, back good. In the day, you think back in Africa, they was it was hot. No, they was getting here. Like,
yeah. Me and him, you know, but we had, that was our first altercation with, you know, a female. We had one.
But that's how I really met him, though.
Yeah, that's how we met. He was...
I was like, I was like, that nigga was creepy as hell. Why the hell was he in the room?
I just sitting there staring, goddamn it.
What the fuck wrong with this nigga, man?
I was recording at the time.
I'm doing my damn little say, hey, you know what? I gotta go.
It wasn't no homo. I was like, that she really doing this. I was shocked. I never seen nothing like that before.
I've always seen stuff like that.
But she just did it with no problem.
Because I made the vibe.
I don't know.
The vibe
she
God.
Did it with no problem.
The vibe guy.
Coming in the store soon. The vibe guy.
But yeah. But the the memes. We started, you know, doing that. Okay. And we just like, we got another mutual friend named Flea. Yeah. And he's a businessman. So everything he thinks is money, money, money. Oh man, we could do this to get money. So we just started doing videos.
Yeah, he put us together and all that. Okay. When he was like, man, work with him, testing, man. That nigga was watching me when I was having sex. That's how I don't know if I should work with him. Yeah. But, I mean, I said, all right, Flea, I got you, bro.
Yeah.
And then I think Cam was just there.
We went to a cookout.
We went to a cookout, and Cam was doing, was he doing them too?
He was doing memes too.
Right.
He was doing memes. But his page got deleted like a good 4 times. Because he's like, his name is Creep. So he put stuff up there like pussy shots.
Yeah, he was going hard.
He do a lot of.
I forgot about that.
I didn't know like Creep get down like that. I follow Creep.
He did that when he first started.
Yeah, when he first started. Oh, when he started deleting his stuff, he just like fell back off to all the nasty stuff.
Damn.
He a nasty dude,
so
too.
So that's how he got the name Creep. Because I'm like, you know.
He won't really tell us how he got his name. I know how to tell a story. Like, I was in one interview and Waffle wasn't there. I was able to say how he got his name, but Creep just won't say how he got his name.
Got it.
He must be weird for him.
Yeah. We just know he the DM slider. He'd go in anybody DM.
Yeah, he slid in my cousin DM.
Yeah, he'd be in anybody DM. Like he don't care who it is.
I didn't like that.
He'll say, let me see your feet. He won't even say, hi, how you doing? Start a conversation on. He'll say, let me see your feet. Now, that's some creepy shit, eh?
Yeah, you know.
That's his greeting.
The typical creep says something like, what that mouth do or something like, let me get a pic. But he said, let me see your feet.
Yeah, he want to see. That's very direct. He like feet like me. That's one thing we got in common.
Yeah.
That's funny.
Yeah.
Now, like, I know, like, both of y'all wearing merchandise and all that stuff. So, you know, we always like to shout out the business of what Brothers is doing around here. Okay. I mean, obviously, y'all, you know, comedians in the D.C. area. Obviously, you know, if y'all don't follow them on Instagram, y'all need to follow them for real. Like, get the support up for them.
Mr. Almighty_Waffleman on Instagram.
That's what's up.
Mr. Waffleman on YouTube with a period, I think. Well, it may not be a period. I don't know. But who's asking?
And I'm Stickem _ Johnson, STICKEM_ JOHNSON on Instagram and Facebook. I only got those two social media. And YouTube.
And I know a lot of y'all videos and stuff, y'all advertising your shirts. Y'all got some dope sweaters, like the designs and stuff that y'all have.
Yeah.
Really cool. Where can people buy that stuff and purchase it?
You got to DM us.
DM you guys, sir.
DM us. You know, we don't have a website. We had a website at first, but we was we didn't feel like, you know, we was getting accommodated what we deserve. So
got it.
Now we just DM us and we'll pull up on you.
Pull up.
Yeah, we'll pull up on you.
And y'all, and you talked about, like, you know, people working in cliques. Like, you know, for instance, like, you got the people in Cali. I remember I mentioned Jahan Jones. I know he's originally from this area, but I know he's like, he's deep in with the Cali cats. The Cali, you know, cats. ADD, Redo Brown, all those guys, right? Mm-hmm. And I see you guys kind of creating your own format here, because I noticed there's about three young ladies in general, two especially, the side chick, main chick that you use. And then I seen about two that you use also, Waffle, that are going there. Are these like friends of y'all's, like family friends that kind of came up with y'all? Are these people y'all met once y'all were already on the scene doing your thing?
Yeah.
And y'all can feel free to shout them out too.
On the scene, yeah.
On the scene. Yeah. Well, you know, yeah. 50 Shades _ Petty. That's my girl right there, Brady right there. She funny. You probably seen her in a little idiom jokes I'm doing when I had Creep, had the elephant mask and all that stuff. She wild. Mm-hmm. Karina, Cora, she cool as a mug. I met her through Stickum, though. Just, you know, stuff like that. That's how we meet them. Hashtag Nike babe. She workout queen. All she do is lift weights. She smell like sweat. She funny though. She cool though. She don't smell like, she do smell like sweat, I'm sure, when she sweat. You know what I mean?
And shout out to Bree and Brittany. And the Spanish Brittany, Puerto Rican
Spanish
princess.
Brittany. Shout out to Spanish
Brittany. And Dynasty. You know, we probably should, like, make them a part of the team. They are part of the team, but, you know, they don't come on events like this.
Yeah. Know? I mean, I've always kind of considered them, like, extended CTFU, because, I mean, they in a lot of the skits. They super funny.
They on the team. They definitely on the team. They supportive, you know.
Right.
So.
I shout Debo out, too. My nigga Debo.
Yeah, Debo, man, Debo.
I know he ain't a girl. He played girl a lot on the jumps, but yeah. Debo, he funny as a mug. And Rico. All right. And Flea.
And we got our man Pat right here.
Pat.
I thought he was care to be in the videos and shooting and stuff.
What's the page, Pat, for the
picture? Yeah, he take pictures.
For your jump.
And he don't want the
We'll let y'all know, man. Just it's DM. Like, we'll let you know. He a photographer. He'll do what he need to do, man.
You not going to tell him, man?
Well, I just want to shout out the Cavaliers because we pulled out them brooms today.
Where did that come from?
Shout out to the Cavs.
I'm
not hating on the Cavs.
216.
Cleveland, y'all had a big year already. Huge year. Already.
God bless.
Where to come?
Are y'all Skins fans, Wizards fans? Hopefully, y'all got Cowboys fans. Because y'all got to leave if you're a Cowboys fan.
I'm a Skins fan.
Right, I'll talk to you later.
Oh, no, wait a minute.
You a Cowboy? You a Cowboys fan?
Yeah, I'm a
Cowboys
fan.
How are you from DC or the DMV period? Because
that's what my daddy raised me to be.
Hey, I'm from Cleveland, but I'm not a Browns fan.
That's what my daddy raised me to be.
I
hear so many people from the DC area talking about, I'm a Cowboy fan.
Yeah,
I was raised that way. How can you be raised wrong?
That ain't raised me wrong.
It's like how it's like how the people in this area do. They go for the popularity. Uh-huh. You know what I mean? They don't go for the I can't say Redskins talent, but they don't go for the home team.
No,
they go for the go for the popularity.
You know, Dallas ain't too popular.
I used to be a Cowboys fan.
That's how you do that.
When I was little, I'm telling my story. When I was young, I used to like that. You know what I mean? Emmitt Smith and Troy Aikman and Michael Irvin. You know, man, I knew he was on the Molly back then, but they was amazing. I was a Cowboys fan, and I used to always go to family events and my
wrap it up.
All
right, guys. Well, it was such a pleasure having you.
No, we got 5 more minutes. We good. He's just getting the 5 minute countdown.
It was a pleasure having you guys. Stickum and Waffle, thanks for coming.
No
by.
Problem.
Thank you
if I offended
for coming.
Anybody, but
no, it's too
I
late.
I know the way I feel. You know,
it's too late.
I'm not trying to, you know.
No, that's what I love. That's a great thing about the Nitty Gritty. We welcome diversity of thought.
That's right.
And we
a thought.
Yes, we like various opinions. We don't judge. It's no judgment zone here. No judgment zone.
Can I shout out my man?
Go for it.
I want to shout out Flea and Ocho. They just text me and let everybody know they're from the bottom of the map. Waldorf, Maryland.
Yeah.
Right now.
Yeah, Waldorf is the bottom.
Yeah, Waldorf,
St. Charles
Maryland.
County.
Yeah. Shout out to them.
That's what's up. Well, we definitely appreciate y'all coming on. Young brothers doing y'all thing. Once again, give them the ads at Instagram and stuff so they can follow y'all.
At Stickum Johnson. Stickum _ Johnson. There you go.
And Mr. Almighty _ Waffle Man.
And of course, this is the Nitty Gritty Show. Make sure you guys follow us on Facebook at the Nitty Gritty Show. Subscribe to our YouTube channel at the
the Nitty Gritty Show on YouTube, and also follow us on Instagram and Twitter.
That's it.
All
right.
That's it. It's a wrap. Hey, it's the Nitty Gritty. Thank y'all.
Thank you.
Nitty Gritty.